The amount of fuel in an area, or fuel loading, is measured by weight, either kilograms per meter squared or tons per acre, and is a very important metric for calculations of fire behavior and fire effects, such as soil heating, nutrient dynamics, and water infiltration rates. For example, fuel loading determines the flame length and intensity. Fuel loading also determines smoke emissions and how long a fire burns for, which affects soil heating. Do you have to sacrifice time and energy for accuracy? Can only highly trained professionals collect accurate results? No! The photo load sampling technique can be used to quickly and accurately estimate loadings for the six major surface fuel components by using downward-looking and oblique photographs depicting sequences of graduated fuel loadings. The six components are the four size classes of downed dead woody, 1 hour, 10 hour, 100 hour, and 1000 hour, shrub, and herbaceous fuels. In this video, you will learn what is the photo load method, how to use this method to estimate dead and downed fuel loading, estimate shrub and herbaceous loading, estimate log loading, and calibrate your eye so you can readily estimate fuel loading. What is the photo load method? The photo load method involves visually comparing fuel conditions observed in the field with a series of photographs depicting a range of fuel loadings. Photo load sequences are a series of downward-looking and close-up oblique photographs showing graduated fuel loadings of synthetic fuel beds for each of the six fuel components, 1 hour, 10 hour, and 100 hour, shrub and herbaceous, and 1000 hour, or logs, which can be measured by visual comparison, or tables. The weight of these synthetic fuel beds have been measured, so by comparing your fuel bed to the reference fuel bed, you'll be able to get accurate approximations for the loading on your site. Plots should take roughly 3 minutes apiece to complete, which is about 1/15 of the man-hours needed to get a similar quality estimate from the planar intercept techniques. How to estimate fuel loading with the photo load method. You will need to purchase, obtain, or make the following equipment for use in photo load sampling. Plot frame, a square meter plot frame with the square meter area measured on the inside dimensions of the frame. You can construct this out of wood, PVC pipe, or metal rods. Go-no-go gauge, a device that has the width of each woody size class, upper diameter range. Clear plastic ruler, a ruler that can be conveniently stored in your pack or pocket. This ruler will be used to estimate log diameters and branch lengths. It can also be used to measure duff and litter, if needed. Cloth measuring tape. The length of the tape would be dictated by the sampling design. This tape would be used to locate sampling points. Pencil and clipboard. Be sure you can quickly reference the photo load pictures and record the results. Nails. Long nails, greater than 20 centimeters, are handy for anchoring long microplot transect lines, either permanently or semi-permanently. Photo load procedures and sequences. We suggest that the photo load sequences be cut from the instruction document and laminated to waterproof pages. Photo load has microplot and macroplot methods, and both are described in detail in the photo load manual. This video only deals with photo load sampling at the microplot level, where the sample frame is a 1 meter by 1 meter square microplot. The microplot approach is easy, fast, and provides an excellent estimate of true fuel variation. Once practiced at the microplot method, you'll be ready to practice with the macroplot method, which is simply to perform the same fuel loading estimates just outside of the frame, with more of a general estimate of loading for the entire sampling area. We made our plot frames out of plastic PVC pipe and glued 90-degree corner pieces to each length for easy construction, deconstruction, and storage. However, any material from wood to metal bars will do. Photo load can be easily incorporated into already existing sampling designs. We recommend randomly establishing a starting point for the first transect, and then establishing a systematic grid that evenly places the microplots across the entire sample unit. Our research has shown that at least 4 and at most 14 microplots are needed to capture fuel loadings within a 10th acre or 400 meter squared area. Detailed directions and sampling tips are included in the Photo Load Sampling Techniques publication, hereafter referred to as the Photo Load Manual. This video will cover the overall techniques, but not go into some of the sampling details. The most important guidance for estimating loadings of fine woody components is to first correctly identify the right fuel components. Three questions must be answered for the observed fuel to be sampled. Are the fuels down, dead, and woody? It's important to note that the fuel load method is not used to estimate the loading of duff and litter, which can be a significant portion of the fuel loading on the site. You can collect information about these fuel components in combination with the photo load measurements you are taking. For example, you can sample the duff and litter a certain distance from two of the corners of the microplot. To demonstrate the estimation of fuel loading with the photo load method, we will be using one of the examples from the publication A Visual Training Tool for Photo Load Sampling Techniques, or GTR 242, also known as the Calibration Guide, which was developed to help train your eye to accurately estimate loading. Estimating fuel loading with the photo load technique involves matching the conditions observed on the ground within the sampling unit with the conditions in the set of photographs of loadings provided in the photo load sequences. Let's start off by going through the photo load process with a simple fuel bed. First, identify your 1 hour time lag fuels. Using a go-no-go gauge can be very helpful in distinguishing 1, 10, and 100 hour fuels. Now look to the photo load manual and find which picture you think overestimates the amount of loading for 1 hour fuels only. Which one underestimates the amount of loading? What do you think the fuel loading is? Estimate your loading based on where you are in between those two images. In this example, we have now determined that our 1 hour fuel loading is between 0.32 and 0.45 tons per acre. What do you think the actual fuel loading is? Let's see how close we are to the value from the calibration guide. Let's try now with the 10-hour fuels. Which image is higher than our sample? Which one is lower? What do you think the loading is? Pause the video if you need a chance to think about it. Let's see what the calibration guide says. Now let's measure the 100-hour fuels. Which image is higher than our sample? Which one is lower? What do you think the loading is? Pause the video if you need a chance to think about it. Let's see what the calibration guide says. We can now add up our fuel components to get our total loading for 1, 10, and 100 hour dead and downed material. So what do you do if you have a piece of fuel in your plot that is part 1 hour fuel and part 10 hour fuel? You simply treat it like two pieces, with one counted in the 1 hour category and the other in the 10 hour category. It's important to realize that there is a variety of loading variations depending on the exact diameter of the fuel particle. Breaking them down into 1, 10, and 100 hour fuel is convenient, but can lead to slight variations in loading estimates. Pay special attention to the range of diameters in both the photo load sequence and in your sampling unit. Some of the images in the photo load sequence may not have the range of diameters observed within the sampling unit area. Therefore, your estimate of loading may need to be increased or decreased, depending on the differences between diameter and distribution. So what if some parts of the fuel particles are buried? How are rotten logs counted? How can you measure litter and duff loading? Curious? See the photo load manual for this and other more detailed information. To review, to determine loading of dead and downed, first, start with 1 hour fuels. Select which photo load sequence best represents your sampling unit 1 hour loading. You can visually estimate to find a match, or you can use the measurement technique. 2, adjust loading as necessary depending on differences in average diameter. 3, measure loading for all size classes. And 4, add all fuel loadings together. The first step in estimating shrub and herbaceous loading with the photo load technique is to identify the plant species within the sampling unit. The user must estimate loading by matching the group of species occurring on the site with one or more of the photo load sequences. Since the photo load guide contains only 7 shrub species, 2 grass species, and 2 forb species, you must match the morphology of the species observed in the field with the species present in the photo load sequences. In other words, you pick the species from the photos that looks closest to what you have on the ground. If there are several species of vegetation on your plot, you may choose to use several photo series, one for each species, and then sum the individual loadings to make a final loading estimate of shrub or herbaceous components. Or you can rate the loadings as a collection of species using the most similar photo load sequence. Finding the appropriate picture in the photo load sequence is a bit more difficult for shrub and herbs because these fuels have depth, or plant height, species differences, and heterogeneous distributions. For shrubs and herbs, the user should try to match the pictures with the field conditions based on three characteristics: species, cover, and density. Let's look at this example from the calibration guide. First, we need to select the correct reference page. For this example, we will measure the fuel loading for all species together. The reference page that most closely resembles our site is page 30 of the Photo Load Manual, or Bare Grass. Next, we select the picture that best represents the cover and density. We start by finding the picture that we feel overrepresents, and then we settle on a loading. What do you think the loading is? Once a picture is chosen, then the corresponding loading must be adjusted for differences between height in the picture and height in the sampling unit. The average height of each plant photo series is indicated at the top of each page. In this example, the height of the vegetation is the same as the height in the reference. From the calibration guide, we see that the loading is 0.47 tons per acre, or 0.11 kilograms per meter squared. So what would we do if our fuel bed was not the same height as the reference? Even with the same amount of cover, there is going to be more loading in a taller fuel bed. If the sampling unit fuel bed is 14 inches and the reference fuel bed is 10 inches, that means our fuel bed is 1.4 times bigger than the reference fuel bed. The estimated loading for a 10-inch fuel bed is 0.47 tons per acre. So, 0.47 times 1.4 gives us an estimated loading of 0.67 tons per acre. We can do a similar adjustment if our fuel bed is shorter than the reference fuel bed. For example, if our fuel bed is 8 inches tall, then our fuel bed is only 80% of the reference. So 0.47 times 0.8 gives us an estimated loading of 0.38 tons per acre. Remember, this is a measurement of surface fuels only, which means that any vegetation above 6 feet tall is not included. See the photo load manual for details on what to do in this situation. To review, to determine an adjusted loading of shrub and herbs, 1. Choose a shrub and herb photo load sequence that best represents the vegetation in your sampling area, matched to the closest species, genus, or morphology. 2. Visually estimate the loading using standard photo load procedures. 3. Estimate the height of the shrub or herb present within the sample unit. This is estimated as an integrated average across the entire sampling area. A hint is to visually drape a sheet over the shrub or fuel component and estimate the average height across the entire sheet. 4. Calculate the height ratio, divide observed height by photo load height, and multiply the ratio by the loading estimate to calculate the final height. And 5. Estimate final loading by multiplying the visual estimate of loading by the height ratio. We recommend that shrub and herbaceous loadings be estimated when the plants are still green and at the peak of their growth, end of the growing season. However, this may be impossible for many sampling efforts. Users should avoid sampling too early in the year before new growth and too late when some plants have been eaten or deteriorated. If early or late sampling is the only option, be sure to only rate the fuels that are observed at that time. Do not try to recreate optimal growth, unless the sampling objective requires that you adjust for phenology. Log loadings are estimated at a different scale than the other fuel components in the photo load technique. Logs, because of their large size, are estimated at a subplot level, meaning that you are looking at an area 100 meters squared, or 10 by 10 meters, to match the photo load pictures and tables. The photo load pictures are useful for general reference and quick estimates, but a more accurate, reasonably fast way to estimate log loading is to use the tables. To use these tables, the user simply estimates the average diameter of all logs within a 100 meter squared fixed area, and measures the length of the logs in the area. For example, in this plot, there are roughly 4 logs, the diameters of which are 7, 8, 12, and 13 inches. For the loading calculation, we will need the quadratic mean diameter, which is calculated by taking the square root of the average of the squares. So, 49 plus 64 plus 144 plus 163 divided by 4 equals 105. The square root of 105 is about 10 inches. In the plot, there is a total of 32 feet of log. You can also look up each log individually with its length and average diameter. With a quadratic mean diameter of 10 and a total length of 32 feet, we get a loading of about 10 tons per acre. How do you adjust for rot in the logs or the density of the different species? These and other details, along with additional techniques for accurately measuring 1,000-hour fuel loading, can be found in the PhotoLoad manual. Calibrating your eye for estimating loadings. It's important that users of the PhotoLoad technique calibrate their eye so that they can consistently and accurately estimate loadings. Users consistently underestimate moderate to high fuel loads and slightly overestimate low fuel loads. The calibration guide was produced for this purpose. Another way to calibrate your eye is to estimate and then actually measure the weight of shrub and herbaceous fuel in your area. This process can be completed in just a few hours in the field and enough time to dry the fuels. You first identify areas where only one species of shrub or herb exist, at least as close as possible. Identify an area with a very low loading and an area with very high loading. Then, at least two levels of loading in between. Take oblique and side pictures of your plots. In your sample plot frame only, remove all the vegetation with shears of some kind or a saw and bag the materials. Allow the material to fully dry and then weigh. By creating your own collection of references, you could have a photo load guide for your specific area and species, which can be a great reference and teaching resource. Instead of having to estimate loading around the species currently provided in the photo load manual, you could increase the accuracy of your sampling by having more site-specific references. In summary, we suggest that each visual estimate of fuel loading follow these guidelines. 1. For each fuel size class, select two photo load pictures that bound the observed loading on the sampling unit, one higher and one lower. Compute a loading estimate by extrapolating between pictures. Adjust shrub and herbaceous loadings for fuel bed depth. Adjust dead and down loading for differences in diameter for large woody fuels. Measure logs and use the tables to calculate loading. The PhotoLoad technique has been shown to be very easy to learn and produces very accurate results. With the PhotoLoad technique, you can quickly assess the loading of downed and dead woody fuel, including logs and also shrubs and herbaceous fuel. This technique is flexible and useful for a variety of different fuel beds and sampling protocols. The PhotoLoad manual and the calibration guide can be found online and can also be ordered from the Forest Service Publication Department if there are copies available. You can also create your own PhotoLoad reference page or local PhotoLoad reference photos. Remember, if you want accurate outputs from your fire behavior and fire effects models, you will need accurate inputs.
Happy sampling!